Hello everyone, my name is Michaela McDowell and I'm a lead peer mentor here at Equip. In my work with patients and my own eating disorder recovery, I've spent a lot of time unpacking the challenging feelings that come up around binging. One of the biggest questions that people have is, what are you supposed to do after you binge? It is an understandable question because the minutes and hours after a binge can be quite distressing. But the good news is that there are positive things you can do to make the post-binge period more manageable and prevent future binges. First, let's explain what it means when we talk about a binge. A binge is defined as eating a very large amount of food in a short period of time, past the feeling of fullness, and often to the point of physical discomfort. During a binge, people usually feel a loss of control. Binge eating is a symptom of a few different eating disorders, including binge eating disorder, bulimia, and anorexia binge purge subtype. But people without a diagnosable eating disorder sometimes also binge. After a binge, it's common to experience really distressing feelings like shame, guilt, or disgust. So what can you do to manage them? First, let's talk about what not to do. Post-binge, a lot of people feel an urge to make up for the binge by exercising, purging, or restricting food intake. But this approach is always a mistake. Trying to compensate for a binge with another disordered eating habit only keeps the cycle going. Plus, it doesn't address any of the underlying issues that might contribute to binge eating. Here are some things you can do that will help you feel better in the short term and contribute to positive change in the long term. You can reach out for support. Binge eating can be isolating, and talking with the people you care about can remind you that you're loved and that you are so much more than your binge eating. You can talk with them about what you're struggling with or just talk about them for some sort of form of connection. It could also be helpful to go for a gentle walk. This isn't exercise to make up for the binge, but rather a mindful movement that keeps you mentally reset and may also alleviate some of the physical discomfort that comes after a binge. Maybe the toughest but most important thing to do after a binge is to continue to nourish your body. It is normal to feel the impulse to skip your meal the next day or eat a very small amount, but this contributes to disordered thoughts, patterns, and makes it more likely you'll binge again in the future. Remind yourself that your body needs and deserves nourishment every single day. And lastly, if you're struggling with a pattern of binge eating, get help. Eating disorders don't go away on their own, but with the right support, lasting recovery is possible. Talk to your doctor or an eating disorder specialist about your concerns. You can also reach out to our team here at Equip to talk about your concerns and learn about our virtual evidence-based treatment for binge eating.